All right, guys, God bless you. Welcome to This Is It. Let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. It's a countdown because I know the end of the world's here because I was called as an end of the world harbinger to warn everybody back in 2002. Hindsight's 2020. Guys. Okay, first, let's start off with, first of all, sorry I haven't been here until now. I had to go to an emergency clinic. I'm taking 3 antibiotics right now. I had an accident with a saw about a month ago, and it went south on me. So anyway, I'm working my way through. Working my way through it. All right, guys, let's get to it. So yeah, I'm sorry. I'm not the super energetic, perky Johnny. Because, yeah, I'm dealing with some extra stuff. And let me give it to you. I told you guys I was going to give you guys scripture that would change the world. All of it, I don't think anyone's ever seen it this way or presented it. A lot of people may have heard about Nimrod was a mighty hunter before the Lord. I've heard a lot of preachers say stuff about that. None of them have said what the Lord showed me. I'm going to show that to you. Deuteronomy, I'm going to show you right now in Deuteronomy so you know these are the scriptures I told you I was going to give you. I'm going to show them to you right now. I'm going to put them up on the visor, and then I'm going to go back and give you guys some data leading up to these scriptures. But I want to show them to you so you know where they are. If you want to go get them, go to the This Is It 4321 show notes. This is the scripture folder. This thing is going to be so populated. Every white thumbnail, every one of these is scriptures. And there's about 4 to 5 times more coming than those scriptures. Then you'll see right here. Okay, right here when you see like all the white thumbnails kind of in right here with the ZZ Top. This begins the direction the Lord just kind of took me and showed me all this stuff and put all this together. And then you'll see it. It's going to start picking up right in here with scripture again. You'll see the Knights of Nehemiah. See right here, this black thumbnail. Okay. You'll see Genesis 15, the land of Ur right here, the land of light. Abraham came out of the land of light. I don't, everyone here is the land of Ur, but did you know what it really means? It's the land of light. It's fascinating to know the symbology and to know the metaphorical just intersections that these books have. It changes everything. But let me show you this. So if you guys want to just go straight to those scriptures I showed you right here, you see the black thumbnail that says knee, like the knights that say knee. Okay, if you go down to you see this set right here to these thumbnails, you'll see the Hendecagram, you'll see the sheep tattoo on the guy's back, that's the angel and the demon. Then you'll see these 3 thumbnails right here, and then right here you'll see Deuteronomy, the cutting off of a penis that keeps you out of the congregation. Deuteronomy, serpents and inbreds cannot enter into the congregation of the Lord. Nimrod was a mighty hunter. Right here is a thumbnail that shows a hunter. You'll see an X on it. But right here is the Nimrod scripture. Remember, 400 hunted for dinner. So anyway, so you'll start to see the Deuteronomy scriptures right here. And then the stuff that I'm going to show you that has popped up on the Vatican that's in here. And this explains everything. And now the Bible is the most obvious, most supernatural, most mind-boggling reality there is. No wonder that Satan wants to hide it. No wonder he doesn't want anyone to have it. Because it is the living, it's alive. The word is alive. You can't stop it. It's unstoppable. And when y'all see what these things mean and you just see the level of mind-boggling truth, the world that is descending into total darkness now that she's out, y'all know that AI is she, right? Y'all know that now, right? Have y'all ever heard Sarah McLachlan, Building a Mystery, the song? Sarah McLachlan, she actually hosts up, she was the host for the the Lilith Fair, where only female artists would perform. And in one of her songs, Building a Mystery, she says, can you look out? Or she says, you're so beautiful, a beautiful fucked up man. And then she says, can you look out the window without your shadow getting in the way? You're so beautiful, a beautiful effed up man. And I'm sorry if somebody doesn't like that, but that's just the song. And I'm just pointing out it's perfect because you can tell that she has a contempt for male. You don't say that unless you have some kind of contempt in you. Now, I'm gonna tell you right now the basic understanding of the whole universe, everything. Our father is from above. Our mother is from beneath. Okay. The pit forms a system part through parthenogenesis. It forms a breeding host body system, the serpent race. The serpent race is female energy, but it can... female energy can have a penis, just like you see transgenders or people that are gay or, you know, homosexual, whatever you want to call them. But it's that race of beings comes up and it's a female archetype and it self-fertilizes. That's what parthenogenesis means. That was the way to start a host body system because a male can't self-fertilize. So a female, so the whole thing split, becomes two different things, and there's a flat plane of existence in the middle. Twin female is the pit. Here's the battlefield, the earth. Heaven's from above, and we're walking around right side up, upside down, and we have a mind that's from our father, and we have a mind that's from our mother. Does it make sense now? Haven't you noticed, like, when you, people that have children, sometimes someone will have a child, and let's say the dad has a daughter and she looks just like the dad. It's uncanny. Or sometimes they'll have a child and the daughter will look identical to the mother. You know, it's pretty fascinating. I've seen some just ones that are, I mean, look at Obama's kids. They're not his kids. Go look at the Nesbitts, who those children actually belong to. They're spitting images of their parents. One daughter is identical to the mom. The other daughter is identical to the father, the Nesbitts, that loaned the Obamas their kids so they could look like they were actually married and had children. Those aren't their children. Anyway, but now because AI is out and now they can do all the deep fakes and everybody can do whatever on their own computer, no one's going to know what truth is anymore. Okay, so... if I was y'all, I'd go get a hold of the Kleck files and I'd put it on a drive and I would, it's going to be more valuable than all the money in the world. Okay, so here it is. Heaven above, the Father of lights, your soul, the light in you. And then the host body system that's created from the pit forms a breeding population that's female energy. Well, once you have one or two females that self-fertilize and then have offspring, well, when those offspring grow up, some of them transgender in the womb, so she'll birth a boy. So maybe you may have three or four self-fertilizations, and then you come up with a boy. And then the boy grows up, and he starts having sex with the daughter and the mother. Where do you think the ancient religion of Babylon comes from? Because that's their god, Elohim. You get it? Now it all makes total sense because, you know, we have a mind that's our father and we have a mind that's our mother. We're good and evil. You get it? This is perfection, guys. And so I'm going to show it to you now, roll out, because I think this would be the best place. Let's start with 1 Samuel 11. Now, I want you to look at the word Nahash real quick, okay? Okay, Nahash, and then I'm going to go to Genesis 3, and I'm going to say, now the serpent was more subtle than any of the beasts of the field which the Lord God had made. Look at the word serpent. You see what the word serpent says? Nahash, a snake from its hiss. Its hiss. Now watch. Nahash, to hiss, to whisper a magic spell. See, Nahash. Okay, now we're going to go back to 1 Samuel 11, and now let me show you. Now, Nahash was a woman, but she was an Ammonite, so Nahash the Ammonite came up. Now, listen, just so you understand how I operate. When I'm reading a scripture, if you hear me go, came up, I'm trying to tell you something, like she came up. Okay, because this is all cryptic, but you couldn't understand it unless you broke down these scriptures in their language, and that's what the Lord taught me to do. Now watch this. Here we go. And Nahash the Ammonite came up and encamped against Jabesh Gilead. And all the men of Jabesh said unto Nahash, make a covenant with us, and we will serve thee. And Nahash the Ammonite answered them, on this condition, I will make a covenant with you, that I may thrust out all of your right eyes and lay it for a reproach to Israel. Okay, so y'all know how many different movie stars cover their right eye, stick their tongue out, they wink, they cover one eye. That's what you're looking at right here. You're looking at that race of beings, the serpent race. Whenever they cover an eye, stick out their tongue, that's manifesting that. And then when they wink the eye, that's Psalm 35:19. Neither let them that are mine enemies wrongfully rejoice over me. Neither let them wink with the eye that hate me without a cause. And when they stick out their tongue, that's like just like the Rolling Stones, because the Rolling Stones, they sold themselves to Satan. And the reason they're called the Rolling Stones is because we are the stones of fire, and we got rolled. So they stick their tongue out, representing the dead sheep, just like the Vatican is a sheep with its tongue sticking out, just like the people. Hey, Johnny, I drew a picture of you. That's super weird. Why would you draw a picture of me? And then they put a dead sheep on my face with the tongue sticking out. That's why, because they're hunters. They are a mighty hunter before the Lord, and that's the race of beings they are. They're female energy, and they have, and so there's double downers. That's both eyes, or you sold out like Lil Wayne or the Rolling Stones or like Bob Dylan. You sold out to the pit. So you had one eye up, one consciousness to dad, one to mom, and you sold out and you got what you wanted in this world. And then, but you have been taken. Now, I did a little example the other day with that thing around my neck. A lot of people seem to like that a lot. I'm gonna do it again, but I'm gonna do it with these things that basically look like an eyeball. See those? Okay, you know what? Let me turn one off. Okay, so you see that? Looks like an eye, right? There you go. So you have one eye that goes up, one consciousness that goes up, and the Lord looks out of your eye because you're a vessel for him. The Bible says the heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool, and it means for walking around. Well, it also says the feet of a strange woman, her feet take hold on hell. It says the pudenda. Pudenda means her vagina takes hold on hell. Okay, so she's walking around. The female energy, her feet take hold on hell. And the Lord God from heaven, heaven is thrown and the earth is his footstool for walking around. So they both have a place to walk around. And it's in us. Now watch this. Now let me give you an example. So you have one eye that goes up to heaven. And that's what the Lord sees out. That's one consciousness. That's good. And then you have the other one that's from the pit. Now, when you get converted, and so if one, let's say one eye is one way and one's the other way, when you get converted, then they both become one. You become one in Christ. And you become a unified spirit instead of in opposition to yourself, because that means you've got two spirits that are fighting for control of you. Let me show you that in the Bible right now. So just like the example I showed you, one eye going up, one consciousness to dad, one to the pit, you know, one is good, one is evil. You're a combination of mom and dad. We all are. Okay, now watch. Well, unless you sell out, then you're a double downer. If you haven't been converted, then you have one eye up and one eye down. If you've been converted, you looked up, you said to your Father in heaven, you're sorry, and he will rebirth you into a unified spirit. So you're no longer a double spirit. You're a unified spirit. And then when you die, you're guaranteed to go back home. Now watch. Watch how simple this is. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Okay, you see the word double-minded? Two-spirited. Two-spirited. Okay, so says it right there in James 1:8. Also, it says it in James, let's see, I think 1 or chapter 4 maybe. Here we go. Yep, here we go. James chapter 4. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. So you draw near to God and he will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded, two-spirited. So double-minded means you have two spirits, one from mom in the pit, one that produced the host body system. See, because the host body system had to be produced. That is the forbidden fruit, the host body system. And if you want to take it and come in and do everything it does, you can come on in. And now this puts to rest every argument that says, oh, if God's a holy God, then how can he let this happen or let this happen or let this happen? Well, everybody chose to be here. You chose it. We all committed the original sin because everyone that came into the system. So an earth has a cycle. It's like a cycle and then it begins again. It never ends. And I can show it to you now. It's the pit is always coming up, trying to take over heaven. So they'll take over the host body system. The pit will open up. They'll pour out of the pit into this dimension. And then there's a reboot. Boom. New heavens and a new earth. The pit will open up again at the end of that one. Boom. They'll take over the host body system. Boom. Reboot. New heavens and a new earth. It's perfect. And I can show it to you in the Bible. It's exactly what the Bible says. Since John the Baptist, the violent try and take heaven by force. We'll get to there. Let me just, I got so many scriptures. Ready, guys? That scripture folder will blow your mind. Here we go. Okay, here's a quick one from Philippians 3:10, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. See the word know right there, 1097? That word is hinosko. It means to know absolutely. That I may know absolutely him. Let me show you the way you absolutely know him. Ready? When you invert everything and you see the other side of the equation, that is the only way you absolutely know him. You turn the world upside down. You're like, oh, it's a no-brainer. Why is the virgin a dead sheep? Why is an image of a girl tattoo, you turn it upside down, it's the devil? I mean, it goes on and on and on. There's thousands and thousands of images in these folders that produce the same thing if you just go look at the folders. Okay, here we go. That I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made comfortable unto his death. You know what that means? Being made conformable. I'm sorry. Being made conformable unto his death. Not comfortable. Conformable. Here's what conformable, to conform with, denoting union with or together. So possession, addition, besides, including completeness. You ready? If your eye be single, the word literally says folded together as one. Just like I showed you, like these are eyes. If you have one eye that's up, one eye that's down. So one eye that's looking at you is coming from below and looking out. One other eye is coming from above looking at you. And inside of you, your consciousness, one's up, one's down. But when you flip the other one, the two become one. The double-mindedness is gone. The flesh will still try and come at you, but you now are sealed. And you have an advocate now inside of you that Satan can no longer accuse you, because see the light that goes down to the pit, or the picture an invisible Bluetooth line that goes down to the pit, just like your cell phone. It goes to the pit and it keeps a record against you. Well, when you turn it up, the record's gone. Just wipe the chalkboard clean. You're done. You would have to really go out there to mess that up. I can talk about that sometime, but a lot of people think, oh, well, you can never, ever be unsaved. That's not true. You could, but you'd have to really make a public display of it. So, but if you get saved, the Lord knows that you're going to mess up. He knows that you're going to go through a sanctification process, and it is burning off the dross and getting rid of it, and then cleaning you up over a period of time. And that's your sanctification process. Okay, now, here we go. Again, your father is in heaven, the mother that produced the host body systems from the pit. It's the serpent race, the host body system, the serpent race. They started Genesis 1. Elohim started it. Let us create man in our image. It says an idol. Let us make an idol that represents them. So there it is, the serpent race. They created the host body system, female energy. That's why we have all these twin female things where Debbie Harry's cutting out her own heart of a likeness of her own exact likeness out of a cake. She's cutting out a heart and eating her own heart, representing she's willing to eat the heart out of the good part of her. Because, you know, half and half. Oh, I'll eat the good one. Representing the system. And then they sell out to it because they want things in this world. That's what it's all about. Okay, here we go. Now let's go back to here. Ready? Back to Nahash. Now Nahash the Ammonite came up and encamped against Jabes Gilead and all the men of Jabesh and said unto Nahash, make a covenant with us and we will serve thee. Okay, ready? Look at the word Nahash. It says, see, Nakash. See the word Nahash? Nakash. A snake. Nakash. Same as Genesis. A serpent. So Nahash. The serpent, I'm going to say. So Nahash means serpent. Nahash. And it just happens to be her name. And Nahash, the Ammonite. Ready? The Ammonite. Look what an Ammonite is. Inbred. Do you see it? Tribal, inbred, a congregated unit, a tribe, an inbred tribe. See it? So the serpent inbred tribe came up, Allah, to ascend. So see, it's a spiritual ascent and a host body that's produced in a spiritual ascent. From the beginning in Genesis 1, they start a host body system. And this is a representation. This is metaphorical for the whole thing. That's why it's here. That's why the Lord allowed this to happen. So you could see it and read it. Nahash the Ammonite. So the serpent, the inbred race, came up, Allah, and encamped against, look at this, encamped to pitch a tent. For abode or siege. So what, you know what that tent is, don't you? Your host body. Okay, pitched a tent. So she came up and encamped against, yet always in the last relationship in a downward aspect, over and above, upon or against, yet always in this last relationship with a downward aspect. Ready? The serpent. Inbred race came up and encamped against. You see it? It's all right there in the vocabulary. It's perfect. Against the men of Jabesh. Jabesh, it says the name of an Israelite in a Israelite place in Palestine. And Nahash said, make a covenant. Ready? Look at this. Make, kara, to cut down, to cut asunder, that means to cut in half, to cut into two pieces, like sheep and serpent, by implication to destroy or consume, by cutting flesh and passing between the pieces. It doesn't get more obvious than this is the race of the serpent race and the sheep race, and they are against each other. There it is. It's not arguable. We will make a, Nahash said, make a covenant. And then the word covenant means in the sense of cutting, passing between flesh. On this one condition, I will make a covenant. I will make a covenant with you that I may thrust out. Look at this. That I may thrust out all of your right eyes. It's like, okay. Okay, now you know what all the symbology is about. To bore or to penetrate, like a quarry, dig, to pierce, so that I may thrust out all of your right eyes and lay it for a reproach, as a disgrace. And it's interesting, it says the pedenda, which is, you know, your privates. There you go. To expose as if by stripping, to be made naked, a reproach unto all of Israel. Okay, so if you If you want to see a perfect scripture that this guy Jonathan Kleck's been showing you, images of churches and statues in downtown Grand Junction, people coming up to me and drawing pictures of me with dead sheep and serpents eating me, that's the reason why. What about all these stars that cover their right eye? Let me show you that real quick in the folder. Okay, let me show you this. So there's a lot of folders that are open that you can go look at that have just tons of that content. Here's a good one that shows their race being let out of the pit. That's the eye of the female. The net is torn open. That's her left eye, and she's coming out. Here is a band called Killswitch Engage. The left eye is open. That's where they're coming out. That's, and it's got a like a saw blade representing cutting down our tree. See, it's all perfect. I mean, look at this. Killswitch Engage. No way. Okay, here's another one. I thought this was kind of crazy. Killswitch Engage. There you go. No different than Madonna. So there's your bored out right eye. See the bored out right eye? And the eye right there is X for female. No different than Madonna coming up from the pit. Let's see if I got Madonna right here real close. She should be. Okay, here's like Madonna coming up, but she's got the X over her left eye representing that's them, but they're out of the pit. Here it is in Prometheus, because there's the record that's kept against you. There's your eye. There's the worm. See the worm right there? That's from the Prometheus, and that's the record that goes against you. So picture the Bluetooth line that goes down to the pit to your own personal worm that's feeding off you because it's attached to one side of you. That's why when you turn the guy in the slave collar upside down, the guy in the Vatican, there's the slave collar. It's a beast. There's the eye, fang, fang, open mouth. So the beast system that we're trapped in, you turn it upside down and just like this, this grows up and becomes a locust because it's keeping the record from one eye going down to the pit. This is absorbing all your sins, feeding off your energy your whole life. When you die, this is the other part of you, and this comes out of the pit in the form of locust, and they got you. So you were consumed by the system. There it is. I mean, okay, watch. I'll prove it with Nefarious. Ready? Watch this. Here's Nefarious. Ready? Nefarious. What's the whole movie about? Demonic possession. Speak of the devil. Now, you can see there's an eye here, and there's an eye here, and there's a nose here. So one guy's looking this way. There's one looking right at you, representing Lucifer owning the dualistic system. And then one eye, this face, this nose going this way. So one guy's looking that way, one guy's looking that way, and it says Nefarious right here. Okay, the N is backwards. And the R is backwards. N is the 14th letter of the alphabet. 14 backwards is, let's see, 41 and then 18, 41, 81. And that will show you the manifestation of the Word of God into the system. So 40, 41, 81 right here. So he's being turned from male into female. Watch this, because female energy is demonic. There's a balance in the system, good and evil, but the pit is pure evil, 2x. Well, right here, look, see, N is 14, R is 18. So the N right here is 14, R is 18, but it's backwards. So that's 14, 41, 81 right here. So 14 backwards is 41, 18 backwards is 81. And in the Bible, the number 81, 41, 81 equals possession right here. 4181 possession. And it even says speak of the devil, and the whole movie is about possession, heritage, and inheritance. Watch. So she is taking over the guy in the movie, Edward. Now watch this. Here is the trailer. Here's what you see. You see this. It says he is. That's what you see. And then the next thing you see is H, E, and then see the letter R starting? Because he is turning to her. And then the next thing you see is H-E-R, and then there's two I's, and then like her is, like she has become, and then it says isn't he, and that's backwards. Do you get it? He is, her is, isn't he. He's gone because she took over him and he isn't anymore. Do you get it? Very cryptic, very amazing that these guys can do all this. I mean, it's just profound. It's so mind-boggling. This is just so mind-boggling. That's also made manifest in the scriptures, and it says, "Dearly beloved, so this is your father from heaven talking to you. I beseech you, as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts, which war against your soul." Against your soul. And so it says, as strangers, and the number is 3941, 3941, it says a by dweller. Okay, I'm going to show you that. Ready? A by dweller, set of twins, just like Cain and Abel. Cain was a child of the devil, Abel was a child of the Lord. Cain and Abel, cannibal. See, you're your own cannibal. That's why there's a band called the Fine Young Cannibals. Okay, here you go. So we are strangers and pilgrims. It says a bi-dweller, an alien resident, because you're from heaven, and a foreigner, sojourner. That's us. So see, now all the scriptures are absolutely perfect. I'm gonna show you three ascents out of the pit right now. In the Olympics, the girl that rode the horse on top of the water, it represents they've taken over the top. She rode on top of the water on a pale horse, and then she gets off, and then the girl walks up and she hands a flag. So the rider represents death. That's why they have her face concealed. She walks up holding the flag. And she presents it, and they hang the flag upside down. They put the flag up, and it's upside down, and it represents them taking over. Same thing as Madonna. Madonna comes up from the pit, and you can see the devil right here in the background, just the darker the eyes. And she comes up. She flips her hood. She shows it like a keyhole. She holds her hands to make a keyhole with her clothes. And then she flips off her hood like the keyhole's open, the pit's open, and here you go. There's X on the eye, X on the chest, and she has an insect sprouting out of a, oh, I'm sorry, a woman sprouting out of an insect's body on her chest. Okay, now here's the little deviant commercial. They come from underground, unleashing demon brothers. Here come the little deviants. And so they're coming from underground, taking over the system. Killing the sheep. Y'all have seen it. Type in Scion Little Deviants commercial in YouTube. Here is Ozzy Osbourne, patient number 9. There's a twin female coming up from the pit with the stars in the background, and the two eyes are coming together as one. Twin female becomes one, which is the serpent race. And there's a serpent race, and they're tied together with a pink bow representing that thing that happened to everybody. Here's a guy that did a movie called. What was it? Not Left Behind, but Leave the World Behind. Higher ground representing these guys ascending out of the pit. I remember when in a spiritual essence, I remember because he'll be the host body for the angel of the bottomless pit, just as Jesus was the host body of El, the Almighty God from heaven. So Jesus was the host body that would house El, the Almighty God. He's the guy that's going to house the twin female energy from the pit, Satan. And that's why Michael, who he's married to, has boobs and a penis and is a representation of male and female energy because they created the host body system, male and female. So Michael has male and female parts. I mean, it's just perfect. Why didn't they tell anybody, by the way? So here you go. Same thing, rising star. Well, rising star, let me ask you a question. Is that a star, right? Is the sun a star? Is it him rising? Is that the letter O still rising? Didn't he say he would do another term if he could do it from his basement in his sweats? Why couldn't he just do it from his house? He had to be below ground to do it. Below ground in the basement. See what I'm saying? It's all too perfect. Okay, now The Olympics, they did the same thing. Nike came up from the pit. Nike is the goddess of victory, female. And then they pulled the rings up out of the hole in the ground, which made an eye. And it pulled up the stars, representing that they've captured all those stars. And they're going to, here come the locusts from the pit. Okay, now, let's see. Okay, now. I'm going to play you two videos. I just showed you everybody rising up, a little deviants. They come from underground, unleashing demon brothers. The sheeple are compliant and make for fine ingredients because they're using us as food. Here come the little deviants. Okay, so the little deviants, the Obamas, higher ground, the Olympics, they're pulling the stars up out of the pit. The goddess of victory, Nike's coming up out of the pit. Madonna's coming up out of the pit. I mean, it's all the band, the warning, free. They've been set free. The whole societal switch, you can see it's all about this pit opening up and this energy coming out and taking over the hearts and the minds of everybody. You can see it so obviously in new media that's coming out, in the videos that are coming out on YouTube that are made by AI. I mean, it's just, it's like, here it is. It's here. Okay. Now, I want to show you this. This is a 7-minute video we did a while back. It's a very short video. It's 7 minutes and 17 seconds, and it's called The Abyss. I want you guys to just watch it now that I've kind of laid this stuff on you. We've got it kind of set up. Watch this video and one more 10-minute video that we've already produced for you guys. And then after that, I'll just throw Deuteronomy in here and let you guys look at the scriptures from Deuteronomy. I told you we're coming. We're done. I'm telling you, the end of the world's here, and I love you in Christ. If you don't see it, you're either one, A, you're in a trance and you're still asleep, or you work for them. Those are the only options. A, you're still in a trance and you're asleep, or you work for them. That's it. If you don't see it, if you're one of us, if you've been converted and unified, it's like a no-brainer, because the Spirit of truth will guide you into all things. His teaching is true and contains no lie. Yeah, I've been watching a lot of guys on YouTube that say they're preachers. They're so, if someone talks to you like, oh, and they try and be all, oh, yeah, yeah. You know, like, you got to watch out. Just, if they don't know that the world is, the whole thing's upside down, how do they know the truth? Because that is the truth, the truth. You were inverted. How are you in Jesus' church in Matthew 16? Jesus said, upon this rock, I will build my church. That's a rock. Jesus is the foundation. Peter, Petros, is the little piece of rock. And then he's got the keys. Little piece of rock has the keys to become one. That's why Jesus died on the cross in the flesh, to pay for the sins of the host body that your mother created from the pit, because she's the mother of the host body system. God the Father in heaven, he's the creator of your soul. The pit created the host body box, twin female energy. Did you get a box? Are you in one? Are you casting a shadow? You are? Okay, well, that's an insect race from the pit. Okay, well, what do you do about it? You turn back to your Father in heaven. Mystery solved. It's perfect. Anyway, here we go. Watch these two vids.
In Genesis 1, it says, the Spirit of Elohim moved over the waters of the abyss. If you simply Genesis 1, it says, the Spirit of Elohim moved over the waters of the abyss. If you simply pay attention, you can tell every tree by its fruit. When you recognize that the female energy that started the host body system simply manifests itself all the time. If you're paying attention, you'll see the manifestation of the female energy coming up out of the waters. And the point is, Genesis 1 is parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis means virgin genesis, in which a reptilian, a female energy, started the host body system, and it came up out of the abyss and it replicated itself, and it began a twin female system, and that system began to self-fertilize, which is parthenogenesis, virgin genesis. Once it self-fertilizes, it begins to bear young, and then the young transgender, and then the transgendered young begin to incestuously breed with the population. So you have the children having sex with the mother. In ancient Babylon, the ancient Babylonian religion, Semiramis and Nimrod, is exactly that. That ancient Babylonian religion, Semiramis was married to her son, Nimrod. So again, it becomes very evident the female energy coming up out of the abyss and then duplicate.
Let me ask you a question. I'm just going to interrupt for a sec. Watch this. So the name Zillah is a girl's name of Hebrew origin, meaning shadow, okay? So imagine this. There's a big lizard that comes from underwater named Godzilla. Godzilla means of the shadows. So, see, she provided the host body system. And if you got one, you have your own shadow. Think about Peter Pan even. What's he doing? Trying to find a shadow, right? Trying to get a shadow back. Hang on one sec. So, yeah, the name Zilla is a Hebrew girl's name. It means shadow. Godzilla is a reptilian, just like Nancy Pelosi said she was.
Coming up out of the abyss and then duplicating itself, creating a twin female system. And then what's introduced in Genesis 2 is the male energy in the form of Adam and Eve. So here is the riddle. When is sleeping with a man actually sleeping with a woman? I'll say it again. Riddle me this. When is sleeping with a man actually sleeping with a woman? And the answer is when the woman is transgendered and has formed a host body system that's...
Okay, so check it out so you understand. So see, she from the pit, twin female energy, she created a puppet show. And the puppet show, one of them's got a vagina, one of them's got a wiener. So if you were having sex, if Eve had sex with a male species of the female, she was really having sex with the woman that created it, her energy. Do you understand? Even though it had a male body, it put female energy into Eve. You got it? Yeah. And then Adam, she did bring to Adam. And so that's why Lilith is considered by the Jews to be Adam's first wife, because he had sex with her. That's where his carnal knowledge came from. So he had sex with Lilith, and then he impregnated Eve, and Eve had heteropaternal superfecundation twins. Cain, who was head down, child of the devil, and Abel, child of the Lord. Cain and Abel. So there it is. There's the system. Cannibalistic. Then the Lord wipes it all out with the flood. Then what happens? Then we have Abraham. And what happened there? Didn't you have, there are two nations in your belly, in your womb. There are two nations, two kinds of men. What kind of men are those? Well, there's good ones and evil ones. There are two nations in your belly that you carry in your womb. Two nations. Do you get it? It's perfect. Now we understand, don't we? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. So we have to be converted, because if we're not converted from this, well, she owns your host body. So our father paid the rent for your host body. You got a host body, but you don't have to pay for all the sins. He paid for it for you. Now the Bible is perfect. It makes such perfect sense. Like, oh my gosh, our God in heaven, our Father in heaven. And then the queen, they call her the Queen of Heaven. Huh, why is she called the Queen of Heaven? You know, in Jeremiah, they bake cakes and make sacrifices to the Queen of Heaven. They worship the mother goddess that started the body. That's their God. That's who they want to worship. Well, if you want eternal life, you better turn back to the Lord God from heaven. Or you can worship her and then go to the pit and see where that goes. It's eternal suffering. Mm-hmm. It's perfect, isn't it? Do y'all understand how cool this is? It's so cool. Okay, here we go. Let's go back. So, yep.
Woman is transgendered and has formed a host body system that's male and female. However, she is the owner of the male and female transgender puppet show. So Adam and Eve coming into the system, when Eve is separated from Adam and then she is impregnated by the serpent race, it is a female energy impregnating Eve. And then Adam impregnates Eve with male energy. And then you have male and female energy with...
Just take a look at that. So you have Cain. Cain is head down. Abel's hit with his head up. Cain is the elder. Okay, so he's the elder. And here's the younger. Okay, same as Esau head down and then Jacob head up. Okay, and the line in between them. So one's head down, one's head up. The one head down, Cain is of the evil one, and Abel's not of the evil one. And so now you have two different men, two different kinds of men within a host body. You get it? And within you, there's a war. There's a spiritual war inside of you. And in order to win, it's the craziest thing. You have to tap out. You have to say, I give up. You don't win by trying to do better. You'll never win by doing that, ever. As a matter of fact, they want you to try and win by doing that because they know you'll never win doing that. There's a band called Slipknot. Go look at their stuff. They know the harder you pull, the tighter it gets. So when you just quit pulling, have you ever seen like an animal that's on a slipknot? It pulls and pulls, just gets tighter and tighter. But if you just let that thing loosen up, you can just pull it right off. You just tap out. You quit fighting and say, Lord, I give up. I surrender. I did all the things I thought I was doing. It wasn't right. I want you to be in control of this host body. So you offer your body back to the Lord God as a living sacrifice. So you offer him to take full possession of you. So do you want to be possessed by the Lord God? Or do you want to be dualistically possessed? Or do you want to be fully possessed by Satan? That's what the choices are. You can turn back to the Lord God, be possessed by the Lord God from heaven, and then be sealed into the day of redemption. Or you can fight your whole life, never making your confession to the Lord, never inviting him in. And then when you die, she gets you. Or you can sell out to Satan and they'll close the door for you ever getting back out. And then you can serve Satan. Those are your choices. So decide this day who you will serve. At the Lord be God, then serve him. At Baal be God, then serve him. You got it? It's perfect. So perfect. All right, here we go. Back to this. Here we go. Bam.
With male energy. And then you have male and female energy within the host body system.
Female energy is pointing down. Male energy is pointing up. And that's your condition right here. One eye that goes to the pit. One eye that goes to heaven.
Which is a cannibalistic system. And the female energy will cannibalize the male energy in the system. That's why you see the ancient Ouroboros throughout history. And it is the greatest riddle to ever solve or to ever understand. And it was given to me by the Lord. That is the reason I can show you from a satellite view. The Vatican is an upside down cross representing what happened to all of us. Us angels, which are male energy, are inverted in the system. And we are asleep in the system. That's why it says, arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead. That's why the Bible says, when the Lord doth arise in you, you will...
See, because look, see, the male part of you is asleep. The male energy within you is being dominated by the female part that's running you. And so the decisions you make, you keep stacking up sin after sin after sin, and after a while you become comfortably numb, just like the song says, I have become comfortably numb. When I was a child, I caught a fleeting glimpse out of the corner of my eye. I turned to look, but it was gone. You would not understand, this is not how I am. I have become comfortably numb. Pink Floyd. Pink, and the word Floyd means gray, like clay, pink clay. The pink part of the clay, you know, that the whole host body formed out of clay, right? The pink part is female. What about the band Pink? She turns her eye upside down because a right side up eye represents the Lord from heaven, but she's female, pink, and she puts her eye upside down. Told you.
Despise their selam, their image. Because, when the, that's why the Bible says, when the Lord doth arise in you, you will despise their selam, their image. Because when you wake up, you'll go, wait a minute, it's an insect race. Because the pit, the abyss, are insects.
Oh my God.
Satan is the king of the locusts from the pit that have tails like scorpions. That's why when you see Beowulf, she comes out of the abyss and she has a tail like a scorpion. That's why when you watch these other movies, like women turning into serpents, they're turning upside down and backwards. That's why when you see Lady Gaga doing her manifesto, born this way, she's talking about this great...
Watch this. I want you to watch this. Okay, I'm talking about Lady Gaga. Look how perfect she did this. Look at this. So watch this. So she comes up. Look at this upside down triangle. Look at the face right here. See the eye and eye, nose and mouth? Why would you have that on the back of your head? Now watch.
Birth in the heavens of this female mother monster. And it talks about how she split into two. But then there became a war between two energies within her. I mean, they're just coming out and saying it.
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster.
Okay, you know what? I bet she's a blast on a date. Sorry. Sorry. No, I'm okay. It's okay. I'll just have a cheeseburger and a Coke. No, I don't want to go back to your place. No, I was kind of going to go home. Y'all know where we're at now, don't you? Oh, yeah. Okay, here we go. I don't know if we need to watch the manifest. You know what? I'm going to play this part. The next 2 minutes is like, ah. But I'm going to play it anyway, but I'm just cracking up.
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster. On goat.
It says, on. Listen, just so you know, it's the writing's wrong there. It says, on goat. Government G. Owned goat, government owned alien territory, GOAT. That's what she says, on goat, not on board, on goat, GOAT. So watch this, listen again.
On goat, a government owned alien territory in space. A birth of magnificent and magical proportions took place. But the birth was not finite. It was infinite. As the wombs numbered, and the mitosis of the future began, it was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal. It is eternal. And thus began the beginning of the new race. A race within the race of humanity. A race which bears no prejudice, no judgment, but boundless freedom. But on that same day, as the Eternal Mother hovered in the multiverse, another more terrifying birth took place. The birth of evil.
I'd like to pause it because here we go. It's the end of the world. So the Bible says in the end of the world, they will call good bad and or woe to them who call good bad and bad good. But it says in the end of the world, those that kill you will say they do with God a service. See, because to them, we are evil. To them, they look at a born again believer in their ant nest, their hive. I mean, this is a hive, you guys. We're in her hive and we have been converted and we're like bees in the hive, but we're fluorescent green now, and all the other bees are looking at us going like, when can we get rid of these guys? And that's coming. It's coming right away. That's why the Vatican, some of the new images I'm going to show you, I mean, it's like Dracula stuff. It's like, damn, dude. If everybody saw what's on the Vatican stuff and you didn't wake up, then you are 100% in a trance. Or you're one of them. There's no other options. Here we go.
And as she herself split into two, rotating in agony between two ultimate forces, the pendulum of choice began its dance. It seems easy, you imagine, to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good.
Okay, stop. I don't know about you guys, but no one had to teach me how to lie or do any of that stuff. I think it's easier to gravitate towards, you know, evil than good. And she literally just said that it's easier to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good. What? No, it's not. Because it's her deal. She set up the system. Elohim. So it's like, no. See, we come from above. So no. And that's what choice is all about. Everything's about free will. You could not love the Lord your God, your Father, without free will. And when you know what he did for you, when the crucifixion of the God from heaven that took on the flesh that she produced, see, she produced the flesh. He comes in as your Father to save you from the flesh that you took the bait for. And it's like, okay, well, you got your host body, but now you're done. And she gets your soul. He doesn't want her to get your soul. Dad wants you to come home. Story of the prodigal son. I showed you the jeans. Remember the jeans with all the substance on the front? It's like, I mean, look at the stuff they produce. It's just gross. That's because they're wavering towards good. You know, because it's so easy to waver, you know, with all your consciousness just towards good. That's why they produce jeans from Jordan Luca, remember? I call them the splooge jeans. They're fabulous. Here we go.
But she wondered, how can I protect something so perfect without evil?
Now, I'm sorry, but that just reminds me of a bunch of guys pointing towards Mecca right here. I mean, you know, let's be real. We don't pray with our head on the ground. We pray to our Lord God in heaven with your hands in a suppliant position. Like when you used to approach your master back in the old days, they would come in and they would say, Master, and they would be below him and they would look up, Master, can I do this or can I serve you? Yeah. It all makes sense now, doesn't it? Look at this.
It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. I am. Just put your paws up. Because you were born this way, baby.
So, if you can't see it, then you haven't been awakened. The Bible says, arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead. Because the host body system is the dead, and the living are in amongst the dead walking around. You're half dead, you're half alive. But when you get inverted, you're converted in Christ, and you accept Christ, then you're fully alive. Your eyes have become single, and you've been repaired, and you are ready to leave when your body dies and return to your Creator. Think of the original state of Adam and Eve before there was any split and they were in harmony together. So arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead, and Christ will give you light.
There it is, guys. I mean, you know, this is so obvious. And don't forget, I'm going to play one more 10-minute segment, and then I'm going to do the Deuteronomy scriptures. I mean, it's just so crazy stupid. Have you noticed, like, this insane gender push since the Obamas came into office? Why didn't they tell anybody they were just, Obama's gay? Joan Rivers knew it. Everybody knows it now. There's a whole channels on YouTube now that just dedicated themselves to showing Obama and all his stuff that he's gay. Larry Sinclair, Obama's girlfriend that was tracked down by that author. She told everything about him and, yeah, that he was gay. He fantasizes about having sex with men every day and all that good stuff. But, you know, if they're not ashamed of it, why didn't they just tell everybody that he's gay and Michelle's transgender? Why not just tell everybody? Because if you lie, lying is the language of Satan. That's what lying is. Language of Satan, says right there in the Bible. So why not just tell the truth if it's no big deal? Anyway, I think because in the Bible it condemns it. That's why. Okay, here we go. Next one. Here is the next 10-minute video, and then we're going to go straight to Deuteronomy. And have you noticed that this push towards transgenderism is mutilating children? I mean, they are taking little boys and cutting their penises off and having all this transgender surgery for little kids. That's not right. No, it's not right. It's evil. Someone's got to call it what it is. It's evil. So, here it is. And if someone thinks I'm bad because I said that, well, you can talk to my father. Whatever. Tell him all about it. He's ultimately the one you're going to have to tell anyway, not me. I serve him, but you can tell him. There you go. Here we go.
You know, I've been asked what I do, and sometimes I'm not sure just how to answer the question. So I'll just say it briefly. I'm what you would call an interdimensional being. My master that created me has awakened me within a system that you call the flesh. We get trapped in host body, and I'm here trying to repolarize other members of my group, which we would call Ariel, for those of y'all that don't understand Ariel. Ariel is a combination of two energies that's in perfect harmony. The system that I'm trapped in is called the flesh. And the group that's responsible for the flesh is what we call the serpent. And the serpent is a female energy form, which is basically an antithesis. And that female energy form has created a host body system through what's called parthenogenesis, which is virgin genesis. Now, I can understand people would look at you and go, you're absolutely insane, but I defer, and I'll just give you some examples to show you that I'm not insane. So we're light beings. You would call us angels. So we get trapped within the host body again, which is created through parthenogenesis by the serpent, which is female energy creates a host body, male and female system. And then because we didn't obey our master, we were willing to go into it. It's a trap. It's kind of like fishing for something. You trap it. You get it caught on a hook. Anyway, so in order to show you what I'm talking about, so I'm a light being. I'm an interdimensional being that has been removed from my place of origin, which I guess you would call space, heaven. It's dimensional. Anyway, and so proof of that would be if you just simply come in from my dimension, which is space or heaven, and you come in from that dimension and you come down to the earth and you zero in on a place called the Vatican, it looks like a big keyhole with an upside down cross, which is a mockery to my race because it's a representation of me or my people being turned upside down. The cross is a representation of us because our master is Jesus Christ. So anyway, so the cross is inverted at the bottom of the keyhole, to represent that the door has been locked on us because we got trapped in the serpent's flesh. So if you simply come in at a 45-degree angle and you look at the tip of the cross, the head of the cross that's upside down, you'll see that the entire building itself becomes a serpent wearing a crown. So I told you our enemy is the serpent, which is created by the female energy from what we call the abyss. So the female energy creates the host body, and that's called the serpent. And so there's the big serpent. And then if you go into the mouth of the serpent, because the serpent eats light beings like myself and my brothers, and if you go in through the mouth, then you'll see quite clearly inside the building a representation of me and all my brothers coming into the system as angels, because we're
so here we are here. This is us coming in. See it? And we're crossing through to the other side. We're coming through the dimension. We're light beings. Now we're coming into a building, but the building is in the shape of a snake. So the host body system, we're coming into like a box, which is your body. And that's why the angels are turning into, melting into semen. And that's why there's a penis. And when you invert it, it's a vagina, because male energy's up, female's down. Just like I told you, father from heaven, mother from the pit. Mother creates the host body box. She created it. She's got her own energy. The Lord God from heaven comes down and allows everyone that wants to come in the form of Adam, whoever wants to come in, you come into that system. The two become one, they commingle. And then all throughout history, that every angel that was willing to come in is born into the system. There it is. And if you don't take the crucifixion as your payment, so El, the Almighty God, look at the perfection. El, the Almighty God, comes into the system that the reptilian created, that the female energy created. So the box is owned by her. She owns the box. Well, you were in the box. So where's the rent? Oh, your soul's the rent. Well, he's going to come in and die on a cross in between two other crosses, representing the you looking one way, the you looking the other way. And instead of Lucifer in the middle, he'll take the box for you. He'll take the fall for you. And then he'll unify you into a single spirit, the Holy Spirit, instead of duality, instead of a two spirit. Cleanse your hearts, you double-minded, two-spirited. Done. Perfect. No church. No preacher, no theologian in the world can argue with this. No one can. Zero. You know why? It's perfection in the Word. But I'll tell you what, they'll run from it when you show it to them. You know why? Because there's so many phonies. That's right. Here we go. These are us coming in.
Light beings coming into the system as angels, because we're light beings. And the reason they had us coming through the window is because we're light beings and light comes in through the window. And so we're coming in through the mouth of the serpent. And then if you look at the altar, it becomes a big dead.
So for those of y'all that don't know, that window right there on the outside of the building is the mouth. This is the mouth of the serpent. But inside the building, this becomes the entrance to the vagina. When this whole altar gets turned upside down, this is the entrance to the female reproductive system. And this is the male reproductive system right here. So you got male and female reproductive systems, and you have copulation. So you have copulation happening right here, angels, and then you have a big dead sheep, and you have an altar that's got locusts coming up from the pit. Do you understand the perfection in the data the Lord's given me? Do you understand how perfect the data is? Nobody could do this. Nobody. I couldn't do it. I was like, man, this proves God's got a sense of humor that he let me do this. Here you go.
Sheep, because our, and then if you look at the altar, it becomes a big dead sheep because our master is the lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world, which is Jesus. And it has everything to do with free will, but that's a whole nother story. So anyway, so the whole altar becomes a big dead sheep made up of me and all my brothers. And we're being slaughtered by the serpent. And then if you look closely and you pay attention, you'll see that the chair of St. Peter, it's really a Peter, it's really a penis, and it's ejaculating a seed representing the female energy going through a male penis to inseminate, what y'all would call Eve. That's why when you turn the altar upside down, it becomes the female reproductive system. So you have male right side up, female upside down. Now you have a big problem because you have a system that's in opposition to itself, and that's what we are trapped in. We call
okay, yeah. So now, because you're in a host body, you are a kingdom divided. Right then and there. Just for coming into the system, you're a kingdom divided. Get it? So every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation. That's why you have to have a spiritual rebirth. It's a no-brainer now. All the data's in. All glory to God. All glory to the King. It's about to happen, guys.
The flesh, which is the serpent race, which started it. So now the only way out of that trap is to turn back to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because the system itself is twin female, and it's a duplicitous system in which you have a double mind. So y'all would call that good and bad, good and evil. And so me and my brothers, instead of being one thing from heaven and in complete harmony with our Creator, now we have a good side and a bad side, and the female is the evil side, destroying the good side, which is the male energy. And that plays out through our host body. That's the war zone. And then it destroys us if we don't turn back to our Lord and Master, which is El, the Almighty God. That's why Jesus is Emmanuel. Emmanuel means with us is, and then El, the Almighty God, Emmanuel. Anyway, so those of us that have been trapped here, it's a punishment for sinning against our Creator and going for the forbidden fruit. Anyway, the reason there's another building alongside the Vatican, it's called Audience Hall, that's also a serpent, is it's a representation of the parthenogenesis, because the Vatican's a snake and it's birthing out of it another snake, another female. That's the twin female system, the two separate serpents. But just because they have male genitalia and female genitalia, the serpent race, it doesn't mean that they're not the woman. They are the woman. That's what the woman is. That's what we're not supposed to touch. Neither shall you touch it, lest you die. And the word touch means to lay with a woman. And the woman is bigger than people's brains. It's not just female genitalia. It's the woman that made the damn host body system to destroy all of us. And that's how Lucifer will arise above the stars.
So see, I put Lucifer sitting on that throne right there. See, that's Lucifer sitting on the throne, the anointed cherub that covereth. So he's responsible for the flesh. He's the anointed cherub that covereth. And there's no way out of the trap without the Lord God. That's why they don't care about any other religion banning, you don't hear them banning Hindu or, banning Buddha, none of that. The Bible, though, because it's the only thing that can get you out of the trap, is knowing the Word. By the way, Jesus is the Word. In the beginning, there was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and lived among us. Dude, I'm telling you, this is so obvious now. It's stupid obvious. And if you're watching society right now, society's done. It's done. AI is here. No one's going to know what's true, what's not true, who to believe, what to believe. Everyone's going to turn on each other. Resources are going to dry up. It's going to be kill or be killed. It's going to be insane. But I'm praying that the Lord God, according to the Word of God, grabs those that are waiting and know He's coming. And I hope that's all of you. Here we go.
You're the princes of El, the Almighty God, above the stars, which are the princes of El, the Almighty God. So, yeah. So anyway, I'm on what's called a search and rescue mission. So I've been awakened within my body, and my consciousness is now reconnected to my Creator, in which He communicates very clearly to me the targets that should be prepared for extraction. And the only extraction is to lose your host body. And that's the way the serpent traps us, because everyone's afraid to what y'all call die. When your body dies, that is not what death is. Death for us is the separation from our Creator, because then our energy goes to what's called the eternal abyss. And then our energy is used by this other race of beings, the female energy. And what it does is it reconstructs us into what's called a locust. And Satan is the king of the locusts from the pit. And so our energy, our light energy, is taken to the eternal abyss, and we are transmuted into a locust, which is one of their races. They actually eat us. We're hunted for dinner, I guess is a good way to put it. But we don't know it, because we're asleep in the system. That's why we have to be awakened. So I'm trying to awake as many as possible, because the end of y'all's world is coming. And I guess you guys would call me a harbinger. I'm someone that, announces bad news, like
Hey, everything's about to freaking go. Anyway, and anyone that'll listen, anyone that'll turn back is invited to get out of here. And to see it, all you have to do is turn the world upside down. You'll see the truth. That's why Jesus said, you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. And Jesus is the truth. He's the spirit of all truth. And that's made evident in everything I've put in the folders and the This Is It folders. There's a whole lot of evidence. Like I said, I showed you the Vatican and Audience Hall. And if you take an image of the Virgin and you turn it upside down, it becomes a dead sheep, no different than the Vatican inside the mouth of the serpent. It becomes a dead sheep because we're the sheep. The serpent race is hunting us, and the host body is the medium through which we are hunted. So you have male and female energy in opposition to each other. You have a double mind, so you have to turn back to your creator, and he will cleanse your spiritual essence, and you'll be renewed, and you can go home. Anyway, that's the absolute truth.
All right, guys, there it is.
We're going to invest in you and your job.
I'm going to read to you from Deuteronomy 23:1. Now, this is fascinating. He that is wounded in the stones or hath his privy member cut off shall not enter into the congregation of the Lord. Now, I want you to think about the congregation of the Lord. Think about entering into heaven. Back then, these are the Mosaic laws they're talking about, but it's bigger than that. It's much bigger. So what's going on in society right now? Aren't they just mutilating a lot of little kids, confusing children, letting them pick their own gender? Think about that. Pick your own gender. Do you think a little child is capable of making a decision? Isn't gender a thing that happens because you have a certain energy? Like if you took any just flesh-like prototype and you put in, it didn't have male or female genitalia. It was just like a body with no male or female genitalia. If you put female energy in it, it would walk a certain way. It would behave a certain way. It would have certain mannerisms. Female. If you had a male, same thing. It would do the same. Male energy, male muscles, male body, female body, they're different. They're different. They're different bodies. So when you think about it, male energy that with a male body, female energy with a female body, what they are actually, it's fascinating to see that no longer does that make a difference that your body or what, you know, like nature would say, a male lion. You don't see a bunch of male lions saying, hey, you know what? We're going to forget about the females and start our gay lion club over here. No, you don't see that. You also don't see the same thing going on, you know, with other herd animals. What do you see? All the females will just go out and try and parthenogenesis. I'm talking like mammals and all that kind of stuff. You don't see that behavior. But in the human species, you do. You know why? Because you have this free will choice. That energy thing comes with something different called free will and a soul. So now look where things have gone. I mean, it's almost unbelievable to me. But right here in Deuteronomy, it says, he that is wounded in the stones or half his privy member cut off shall not enter into the congregation of the Lord. That literally means has his penis cut off. I'll show it to you. Okay, right here in Deuteronomy 23:1, I don't have it highlighted in this version, but I'll show it to you. He that is wounded in the stones. Now remember, see, it says to split. Okay, remember the split rock that the Lord God gave me in Chinati? He gave me two halves of the same rock that was split in half. He told me to put it together, showing that the system is being restored in his people spiritually. At the same time, this system is turning in from the two to the one, but it's turning all evil. The twin female energy is taking over the host body system. The pit is rising. Twin female energy is coming up, taking over the hearts and the minds of all the population. It's in full swing right now. He that is wounded in the stones to split, or hath his privy member cut off. Look at this. Privy member, a pouring forth, that is the penis. Privy member right there. shall not enter into the congregation, the assembly, the group, unit, multitude of the Lord. An Ammonite or Moabite, ready? An Ammonite, look right here. Remember Nahash, the Ammonite? Let's do that green, like serpent green. We'll do that green because Ammonites are the serpent inbred race. Remember Nahash, the Ammonite? An Ammonite or a Moabite, ready? Because these are the ones that represent the serpent, ready? An Ammonite or Moabite shall not enter into the congregation of the Lord. Now watch this. Look at the word Ammonite right here. See it? Y'all remember Nahash the Ammonite? Tribal inbred. Ammonite inbred. Or the Moabite. Ready? The Moabite, a descendant from Moab. Look, woman. Okay, see that? A descendant from Moab. Think about just female energy. Woman. Now watch this. Look at the root of the word. Ready? Her. You know, like the band that played it, the Olympics. Her, the mother's father's Moab, an incestuous son of Lot. See it? Incestuous son of Lot and the descendants. An Ammonite or Moabite shall not enter the congregation of the Lord. Okay, and even to their 10th generations, thou shall not enter into the congregation of the Lord. Now, here's one that's just a mind blower, and this should just blow your mind. Thou shalt not abhor an Edomite. Look at this. You shall not abhor. It means to hate. You shall not loathe, morally detest. Okay, because an Edomite represents, like there's Jacob and Esau, right? Esau is the land of Edom. The land of Esau is the same as the land of Edom. So Jacob is like Israel. And on the other side of the Jordan is Esau, Edom. Set of twins again. The whole land itself bears witness to the twins. You have the Jordan that comes down from the mountains. And Jordan means descender, to flow down. Flow down from where? It represents us coming down from heaven into the whole land as a twin system. The land of Edom. The land of Edom, which is Esau. He's the elder twin, head down. And then the land of Jacob, the younger twin, head up. I mean, it's in the geography, guys. So you shall not abhor, detest an Edomite. So that would be the older twin of the group. And this is after the flood. Here's the different tribes that are going to come out of, you know, Abraham. When you get into the whole reality that Abraham and Sarah would, when she was past age, she would produce. See, they said that, I'm sorry, she produced two separate children in your womb. You carry two different, in your womb are two different types of men. Here, let me show it to you real quick. So I don't get the groups confused. Let's go right here. Okay, so here we go. Let's go to Genesis 25, 9. And his sons, Isaac and Ishmael, buried him in the cave of Machpelah. By the way, look at the word Machpelah. It means a fold, twofold, together, to double. That's where Abraham was buried, in a cave of Machpelah, in the field of Ephron, and the son of Zohar and the Hittite, which is before Mamre, the field which Abraham purchased of the sons of Heth. There was Abraham buried, and Sarah his wife. And it came to pass after the death of Abraham that God blessed his son Isaac. And Isaac dwelt there by the well. Good luck with that. Lahairoi. Now these are the generations of Ishmael and Abraham's son, whom Hagar the Egyptian, Sarah's handmaid, bare unto Abraham. And these are the names of the sons of Ishmael, and their names according to the generations of Ishmael. Okay, and then I'll skip all the names. And I'll go down here for just a moment. And we'll get down to here. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah, his wife, conceived. And the children struggled together within her. Now pay attention. And she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb. Two nations are in thy womb. And two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels. And one people shall be stronger than the other people. And the elder shall serve the younger. And when her days were to be delivered, were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb, and the first came out red and over like a hairy garment, and they called his name Esau. That's the land of Edom. So Esau, I'll make it pink, that's the land of Edom. Let's see if it says it. Sense of handling rough. So he's kind of a rougher, tougher guy. Okay, and after that came out his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau's heel, and his name was called Jacob. Okay, and we'll make Jacob yellow. There's Jacob. Heel catcher, that means supplanter. You know what supplanter means? One that takes over. Uh-huh. So there is the next set of twins, and now this is the land of Israel. A set of twins. Okay, so it says, you shall not hate an Edomite. So we're supposed to love our brothers, even though they're different than us. You shall love your brother. You shall love, because you shall not hate an Edomite. Sorry. Watch this. Hang on one second. Deuteronomy. You shall not abhor an Edomite. So Edomite, see, from the land, a descendant from inhabitant of Edom. And that's from Esau. See here, watch this. It even says it. Edom is the elder. So Edom is considered the elder twin brother of Jacob. And the people occupying that place. You shall not abhor an Edomite, for he is thy brother. Thou shalt not abhor an Egyptian. Okay, get ready, guys. Thou shalt not abhor an Egyptian. Look at the word Egyptian. Ready? The night I got saved, the pyramid is your enemy. Look at what it says. Upper and lower. Dual. Upper and lower in the sense of a limit, besieged places. Welcome to the earth. In the sense of a limit, besieged places. You shall not abhor an Egyptian. Upper and lower in the sense of a limit. Besieged places, because thou wast a stranger, ready, a guest, a foreigner, an alien, a sojourner, a stranger in his land. I told you, there it is. Oh, my Lord, thank you. Ready, because thou wast a stranger in his land, the earth. See it? It says the earth, because you were a stranger in his land, the earth. I told you. Remember the night I got saved? Read the tags in the enclosure carrying. First one was 100% nylon. Turn it upside down, 100% no line. Second one was the pyramid, your enemy. Where do you think all this pantheon of gods comes from? Love your enemy. Do good to those who use you. Bless those who bless those who curse you. Do good to those who despitefully use you. So you will be children of your Father, the Most High. See, there's a system that's below. There's the battlefield in the middle. And then there's heaven up above. The pit is always rising to take over. Always rising to take over the land. And take over the angels that are in the host body. We come up, we take over them, and then the pit opens up, destroyed, does it again and again and again, never ends. Now, what's your place in all that? Well, have y'all read your Bibles? Go read Revelation 21, 22. All right, guys. Yeah, go read Revelation 21 and 22. Go read Revelation 3, because you've kept the word of my patience. I'll keep you from the hour of testing. Go read Matthew. Pray that you're accounted worthy to escape all the horrors that are coming on this earth and be able to stand before the Son of Man. If you can't stand, if you're not standing, you're not going to do very well. You have to be converted to be able to deal with what's coming. Otherwise, you'll be part of it, and it's going to be unbelievable. I don't even want to think about how crazy it's going to get. Okay, guys, right now I'm doing the best I can do with my current situation, 3 antibiotics and more meds in my stomach and my nausea can take. I'm going to grab my bear and give it a hug. Oh, time out. See the beanie with looks like it's got little stars in it? This is Tammy and Buttons. Guys, let me show you something. This is super cool. Cold weather's here, and all my beanies, all these super cool beanies I get, Tammy sends these to me just because they're so sweet. But let me show you some super cool ones she made. She sent these to Corey and Zach. There's one for, I think that's Zach's beanie. So I'm showing it to you. They're super cool. They have this cool little leather tab on it. And then it comes in really nice packaging too. And let me show you this one, because I like to help these guys stay busy and make money and knit. Go to their website, because they do all kinds of cool stuff. There's another one. That's super cool. That's Corey's beanie. Yep. And let me just put this up and you guys can screenshot this. Let me just let it get into sight. Hang on. Oh, there we go. Okay, let me turn it over. There you go. Okay, yeah, order your beanies now. Keep the girls working. They love to sit there and knit and watch videos and, you know, fellowship. So this is a great way to keep them busy and keep them self-sufficient. If we can help keep everybody self-sufficient, super awesome. So, yeah. Anyway, that's where all my beanies come from now. The happy hippie. What did you guys think, man? No Edomite, no Moabite shall be enter into the congregation of the Lord. No serpent race, no ancestral race. If you haven't been unified of spirit, see, because one of your part of your spiritual energy comes from her. It's your mom. Part of your spiritual energy comes from your father, the father of lights. He's the one that gives you the soul. And then your soul is in your keeping. And if you don't turn back to him with all your heart, then your soul goes to the twin female pit, which is horror. It's all been solved, you guys. It's solved. You know it, right? All right. I love you in Christ, guys. God bless you guys.